Coach Bo Pelini is a man of many different hats. Passionate, intense, knowledge of the game, and devoted. The one thing Coach Bo Pelini isn't is a follower. Coach Bo Pelini is a leader. On December 13, 1967, Mark Anthony Pelini was born in Youngstown, Ohio. He was the youngest of eight children in the family. Coach Pelini lived in what he calls a blue-collar family. Many people wonder why he has the nickname Bo. Well, Youngstown is where Mark became Bo. Long story short, he and his brothers always played football in the backyard, and Bo was the running back. At the time, the Cleveland Browns had a running back by the name of Bo Scott, hence the nickname Bo. Coach Pelini was always an athlete at Cardinal Mooney High School. When he was in high school, he played football and basketball. Whatever sport Bo played, he played with intensity and integrity. Obviously, though, he is well known for his football career. In an old interview with his former high school football coach, Don Busey, he described some great memories of Bo. If we were going to run up the middle, Bo would point to the inside linebacker and say, "We're going to run the ball right at you." The fullback would say, "No, no, shut up, Bo." When his high school career was over, he was later recruited by The Ohio State University, where he got his bachelor's degree and played free safety. Many people say that Bo is one of the hardest hitting free safeties of all time. My father can recall the play in which Bo annihilated one of the Air Force players in the Liberty Bowl.
I will never forget the most devastating hit I've ever seen in college football. It was Bo Pelini coming out of his defensive back position to hit a player from Air Force. I didn't think the player from Air Force was going to get up.
His intensity and leadership followed him into his senior year, where he was voted by his teammates team captain. When he finished college football, he got his master's degree in sports administration at Ohio University. He then continued his football career, but instead of playing for the pros, he decided to coach. Bo landed his first job in 1991 at Iowa University, where he was a graduate's assistant. He then coached for his former alma mater at Cardinal Mooney High School, where he was the QB coach in 1993. The next year, he landed one of the biggest jobs of his life with the San Francisco 49ers from 1994 to 1996. Bo was the assistant secondary coach, where he helped lead the 49ers to a Super Bowl victory in 1995. After that, his next jobs were in New England and Green Bay from 1997 to 2002. The next year, he landed a job as the defensive coordinator at Nebraska University. He was later fired that year. After that, he was the co-defensive coordinator at Oklahoma University for only 1 year. Before Bo got his first head coaching job, he coached at LSU from 2005 to 2007 and won a national championship game against his old college football team, Ohio State University, in 2007. Now this is where Bo finally lands his first head coaching job. Ironically, it's at Nebraska, where he was fired 5 years ago. While at Nebraska, Bo posted a record of 67-27 in 6 years. Bo is the eighth head coach in college football history to win at least 9 games in each of his first 6 seasons. Now, coaching good players is not the only thing Coach Bo looks at. He makes sure that all of his players are well-educated. In 2013, 19 of his 23 players had earned their degree before his team made the Gator Bowl. Not to mention, he has seen 123 of his players earn first-team all-academic, all-conference honors in his 6 years. Bo himself was a 3-time academic all-Big Ten team. In my personal opinion, I love seeing that in coaches. Coaches shouldn't just always look at a football player's athletic ability. They should also look at a player's performance and education. Well, back to Bo's players. Bo has coached so many phenomenal athletes, such as Kenny Bell, Amir Abdullah, Levante David, and Randy Gregory, who's projected number one in this year's 2015 NFL Draft. Although Bo may have coached some phenomenal athletes, he is not like every other coach. One thing that separates him from the rest is that he is not a fan of signing day. Coach Pelini says it's 12 hours of kids putting on hats on TV. I can agree with Coach because there is no point in watching kids put on hats. Bo had a fantastic run at Nebraska until he was fired earlier last year after the Iowa vs. Nebraska game at the end of the season, where Bo pulled off a victory in overtime. At the end of the season, Bo was interviewed about his job and the staff. He was later fired, but he told his players a great quote before he left. To have core values means you have to be about something. You have to represent something. You have to have something that is important to you. Soon Bo landed his first head coaching job at YSU. In an impromptu interview with Coach Pelini, I asked him about why he came back home instead of going to the NFL. Coach Pelini stated, "I had a bunch of other opportunities. My biggest thing was I wanted to make this my family's last move. Where do we want to move? And where do we want our kids to finish high school? And that's why we made the decision. It was personal first, and it just so happened that this job was open. The stars lined up correctly." Another reason Coach Pelini chose to come back home was because of President Tressel. In another over-the-phone interview with President Tressel, he made a comment. He did a great job at Nebraska, and it's extra special that he is from Youngstown. Youngstown is Bo's home. He even grew up on Applewood Boulevard with my father. He understands how you have to work hard to get where you want to be, because Youngstown is so tough. In an interview with Coach Pelini, he mentioned how he learned his leadership skills here. I think there are multiple people you learn. You learn it from one person. I think it's part of your personality. Part of it comes from experiences, other people, parts of my childhood, obviously in my mother and father, your teachers. Over time, you develop what your leadership style is. There's no one way to learn leadership. Those leadership skills were applied to every aspect of life for Coach Pelini. School, sports, and most of all, the way he coaches. Although the way he coaches does not agree with everyone, simply because he is intense, I'm there for one reason, and that is to serve the players I coach. Over the years, Bo's intensity and integrity has shown on the field. As a result from that, Bo has done what just about every other good coach does. Argue with the ref to defend his players from bad calls and represent his team. Sure, some people may say he's hot-headed or a bad coach, but that's not true. Off the field, Coach Pelini is one of the coolest guys you can ever meet. He is nice, calm, and welcoming. This is the second time I have met Coach Pelini. In both times I have met him, he was never hot-headed. He was never a bad coach. He was always welcoming and nice. Everyone learns from their mistakes, and Coach Pelini can admit that. That's the great thing about competitive sports. Like I said before, Coach Pelini is an intense coach, but that is his style. His intensity is shown through him and his players. Coach Pelini is leaving a legacy, and he wants people to remember it by one statement.
That I want to have is when I leave, I hope they're going to say they coach football team for the kids. Number one, they graduated. Number two, they represented the university, both on and off the field, integrity, and they competed and gave great effort in everything that they did. And I think that the legacy you leave as a coach, especially as a college football coach, goes to what happens to these kids when they leave here. Meaning, I don't get caught up in the wins and losses or anything like that. At the end of the day, our job, I believe my job is to prepare the kids in this program for life when they leave YSU. When they walk out of Youngstown State, that they're prepared for the next step in their life. Be it the NFL or whatever their job is, are they prepared to be the husband they need to be, the father they need to be, if they get married, they get in that situation. All those things are, we're going to help lay that foundation that's going to carry over for the rest of their life. And if we do our job the right way, then they're going to have success, not just for the next 4 years, but more importantly, for the next 40 to 50 years after they leave. That's what's important.